Hello everyone, hi guys, hi ladies and gentlemen online. I'm Elisabeth, I'm a team member and one of the co-founders of Leaders for Climate Action, and we are an entrepreneurial community in the tech sector focused on climate action. So why it needs a global community to drive climate action? Isn't that a surprising question at an entrepreneurial tech conference where it's all about unicorns, maybe zebras, but in any case, building big companies, scaling, creating new markets, conquering new markets. There's this competitive force, right? So what about community and collaboration? Well, if today's entrepreneurs here think about selling products to a mass market that cares about sustainable production and sustainable content, if today's SaaS companies think about how they can convince decision makers in the German Mittelstand, for instance, about environmental KPIs, for instance, then they are really standing on the shoulders of decades of civil community action. Think about the little schoolgirl in Sweden, 14, 15 years old, who decided to take action on her own way. And we know where this has led us. But also think about Germany in the 1980s, grassroots movement for protecting forests from acid rain, or grassroots movements against using nukes for civil use. We are really today standing on the shoulders of all these people who voluntarily, with a lot of dedication outside of their work, with no equity incentive program, decided to take their own action. And that's a little bit what we are trying to replicate in the tech sector with Leaders for Climate Action. So why did we found this organization? We believe that we need more action and less talking to help prevent the catastrophe. We think also the tech industry must take a leading role in fighting the climate crisis, because we, as we all know, software is eating the world, but we also are only standing at the beginning of this digital transformation. So there's so much more to come. And if we, as the startups, the investors at the forefront of this transformation, don't take action, then who should? We believe that a decarbonized digital industry is possible. We can be 100% climate neutral, and we should take the step to show other industries the way. How do we do that? First, community building. Second, facilitating action, and also acting as an accountability partner. We are 100% not-for-profit. We are impact-focused, independent. We are non-political, even though we have different opinions in the team and in the community about political decisions. And we are so far focusing on Europe, but slowly going beyond. So how do we do that? First, we want to start with the decision makers. Why is that so important? Well, 20, 30 years of corporate social responsibility and ESG has often seen these topics in organizationally weak places within large corporates, large PE funds. So we believe it is key to have senior sponsorship in every organization by the co-founder, by the top management, to drive climate action. And that's why we ask from each and every one of our members to start with a personal pledge. Only if you know on your own, with your own lifestyle and your own decisions, how you can reduce your CO2 footprint, then you will feel the impact that you can have through your own business. Once you have done that personal pledge as a leader, we want you to find change champions in your organization, the people who are really passionate about the topic and who can help set up a team to slowly reduce your emissions in scope 1, scope 2, and ultimately scope 3. What have we achieved to date? We have around 1,500 members and counting, of which around 20 unicorns, so happy and also counting. We have some ways to calculate the emissions our members have already reduced and the employees which are represented. Personally, not a big fan of these very large numbers, because we know in the big scale of things, they are still so very small. But we are proud of the members who have joined us, some of European biggest tech companies, Flixbus, Delivery Hero, Dr. Leap. Well, you see the names who are personal members of the organization and who each and every single person of them is very committed. And by the way, we would really need more women founders and ideally unicorn women founders, but also just great entrepreneurs from all takes of life. Why we need to go beyond the immediate sphere of influence. So we all know the sphere of control, usually scope one and two. In many digital companies, scope one in particular seems to be quite easy. Even scope two seems to be okay. But what we really need to ask ourselves, how can we increase climate action in the sphere of influence to our stakeholders? Think of Patagonia, many of you will know that example, who many decades ago realized that if they want their suppliers to become in line with their own regulations, they need to invest in their suppliers heavily. They need to build long-lasting relationships to provide capital to the suppliers for training, and that's not a thing easily done, but Patagonia went that way. And so ideally, we would like to ask our members to take these steps and increase climate action to their users, to their consumers, to their customers, to their employees, investors, everyone. Three examples, actually. We have venture capital funds as members. Some of the most well-known names in the industry, over 90 funds at the moment. And to my knowledge, we are the first and only initiative that actually has launched a legally binding clause for sustainability through each investor, meaning at the time of investment, in the term sheet, in negotiations, but then in the investment documentation, there's a commitment made by the investors, by the company, to set themselves goals towards becoming more sustainable. Those goals are not predefined, but what is required is to have this commitment at a board level and to follow up on it at a board level. This clause has now been adopted by many of our VC members. We are also in discussions with fund of funds, big fund of funds at a public level to see whether they can adopt a similar clause, which would be a huge lever to implement in all VC investments in Europe. There are other examples, like we are regularly doing campaigns. We did a Climate Action Week together with Spotify, over 200 companies. We had a media reach of over 20 million, where we said this week, take time for climate action. You know, think about joining a sustainable bank. Think about your mobility choices every day on the way to work. Do something this week for your own, for climate. We are also having strong community action within our community. So for instance, our e-commerce companies have grouped together, launched through the chat Slack channels that we have, and have developed an e-commerce emission reduction guide. We have over 140 companies working on that, and also external experts who help them to come up with pretty precise actions. You can get a copy of them if you write to me, if you write to one of my colleagues, and very happy to join the community, because it only grows through additional knowledge. We finally, and this is more of our vision, where we want to go, we want to create a climate tech ecosystem where the companies in that ecosystem really help each other, sharing best practices, understanding that only if we do this, if we collaborate, despite all of the, you know, healthy competition and the good competitive forces that drive our markets, but only if we collaborate on how can we tackle this huge challenge, then we can actually advance all together. And I guess by now you already got that these things and examples all have in common, really. Actions are louder than words, and we need unprecedented levels of collaboration to tackle the climate crisis. So we hope we can count on you. I'm Elisabeth from Leaders for Climate Action. Please get in touch over the NOAA app, LinkedIn, anything you want, and we're happy to have a conversation about this initiative. Thank you very much.